I may have an idea here. I'm just thinking out loud, but it's up to us to convince this gentleman that we're right and he's wrong. Maybe if we took a minute or two, you know, try it on for size. Okay, let's start off.
Oh, well. I just think he's guilty. I thought it was obvious. I mean, nobody proved him otherwise.
Nobody has to prove otherwise. The burden of proof is in the prosecution. The defendant doesn't have to open his mouth. It's in the Constitution, the Fifth Amendment. You heard of it?
Well, sure, I've heard of it. I know what it is. Anyway, I thought he was guilty.
Okay, let's get the facts. Number one, let's get the old man that lived in the second floor underneath where the murder took place. 10, 12 minutes after, he heard a loud noise where the murder took place. The old man said it sounded like a fight, and the kid was talking to his father and said, "I'm going to kill you." And they found the father with a knife through his chest. And the corner fixed at the time of death at around midnight. Now what else do you want?
The boy's entire story is flimsy. He claimed he was at the movies. That's a little ridiculous, right? He couldn't even remember what pictures he saw.
That's right. Do you hear that? You're absolutely right.
That's right. She saw the killing, didn't she?
Hold on a minute. Here's a woman lying in bed. She can't sleep, you know? It's hot out. Anyway, she looks across the street and she sees the kid sticking a knife right into her father. She's known the kid all his life. Her window is right opposite of hers, across the L tracks, and she swore she saw him do it.
Through the windows of a passing elevated train?
Okay, and they proved in court that you can see through a passing L train at night and see what goes on the other side.